Hi, I'm Craig Phillips. Now you probably know there's hundreds of hammers on the market for doing a variety of different jobs. I've chosen a small selection that I feel are commonly used around most DIY tasks around the home and garden. Now the claw hammer is probably the most common known and used hammer around. It's called a claw hammer due to the shape of its top head here. It comes down like a claw, designed for knocking nails in and then also levering them out if they're not required. They come in different shapes, sizes and weights. This particular one has a wooden handle shaft. This one is a forged steel claw hammer, probably one of the strongest ones on the market. The claw on the head is the same as most hammers, but the actual shaft goes right the way through the rubber handle. This claw hammer has a fiberglass shaft going through it. It's designed for an anti-vibe traveling through your hand on impact. And the last claw hammer I've chosen is the hollow shaft one. This is a lot more lighter weight for smaller nails. The lump hammer, again, it comes in different weights and length of the shafts. These small ones are designed for cutting bricks using a bolster and also light demolition. This is a brick hammer, again designed for breaking bricks in half, where you hold an individual house brick and crack it on a number of occasions around whilst turning the brick until it breaks where you require it. Now I've also chosen a couple of mallets as well. This is a wooden handle and a wooden head mallet. This is for very lightweight work, often used when using wood chisels. And they can also be used when carpenters are fixing two wooden joints together and they need a little gentle persuasion. Now the rubber mallet, this comes in different shapes and sizes. The more larger ones are for heavier work, like slabs for instance. When you lay them on the sand, you can hammer them down and of course it won't break the slab, but it'll level it into the sand. The more smaller, lightweight ones are often used when people are camping for knocking in tent pegs. But of course they're a lot lightweight, they're a softer material, so whatever surface you're hitting, you're not going to damage it. Now my last two hammers I'd like to show you are more specialised type hammers. This particular one is a ball pein hammer. It's often used by engineers, but it's quite easily identifiable. It's got a hammerhead on one side and a ball along the other side, generally used for hammering and shaping soft metals. This is a Warrington hammer, quite commonly known as a panel pin hammer, generally designed for hammering in real small and thin pin-like nails. As you can see by my demonstrations, there's a variety of different hammers that you can use for all sorts of DIY tasks around the house and garden. If you want some more information, visit the website, silverlinetools.com.